migrants from here that I run out of the country. So, in a way that reflects on some of the things that have happened indeed to professionals and care providers who have fled the country, because I did flee, although I came back in another form. An annoying person who wanted to fight, and so on and so forth. So I share, you know, a lot of, you know, what is in this book. I have read it, she gave me a copy in advance, which I read, and, you know, a lot of, you know, things that you relate with if you have been through the medical school, and the spaces that are described, and what goes on in the different kind of areas. But, you know, I'd like to really echo what was talked about, medicine being politics in itself. Because, you know, a person that you interact with, what affects him is not just what you discover to be what brought that person to you if you are a healthcare provider. But there is a lot that translates into what brings that person. And that was quite often we deal with the end result. It starts with the income, for example. What your income determines your health, it determines your diet, it determines you know, your habitation, where you live. If you live in a slum, if you live where, you know, it determines the hygiene and sanitation that you enjoy, it determines a whole lot of things that translate into what your state of health is. And this is quite often where we don't focus. We focus on, you know, the patients, those who are already sick. You know, we don't focus on health of people, you know, people why they shouldn't be sick to start with. In properly managed healthcare systems, I believe, the care of a person starts before you are born and follow you through till your last hour. You have a file from the time you go to an antenatal care. You know, you have a file that follows you through, that knows when you were born, what happens when you are born, what to expect in 1 month, in 2 months, in 3 months, and continues following you through until you get. Quite often, you know, when I go to visit some of my family members who live abroad and where they register me into their healthcare system, I find piles of notes reminding me, you have turned 60, you haven't done your colonoscopy. we want to fix an appointment for you to do a colonoscopy. We haven't done this on your record. Now, here, what we call patients, they have no record to start with. You know, they just walk wherever they can find whatever kind of help. So yes, the question we are dealing with is a highly political question. The question of what the state of our people is. Quite often, you know, the politicians in parliament, when they talk about the state of the nation, and a lot of time is spent on the state of infrastructure. We have built roads from here to there. We have built a dam. We have built this. We have built this. Never focus on the state of the human being, the malnourished people that we are talking about, the infants, the, you know, the children who are stunted, the mothers who are living, you know, the conditions, the state of the person. Is really never focused on. And, you know, but that's my contribution. Sorry, and let me end on this. My contribution is the question that was asked. So, what do we do? How do we get out of this? And, you know, I am one of those who are indeed always on the firing line. You say, you know, this is going to happen. You know, change is going to come. It has not come. You know, it's like somebody can cause change as a person. It's not possible. it must be each and every citizen of this country, first of all, to become aware of the gross challenges that we have and to take responsibility. And one of the greatest, challenges that I face in whatever I have been doing has been the I don't care kind of system. You know, the detachment, the lack of engagement by the elites of this country. We who are sitting in this room. You know, not engaging, not facing up to the challenges that we have and dealing with them, thinking that someone else will possibly do that, but there are people out there who will. No, it has to start with you. You know, it can't be your sitting in a theater and think that things in the theater somehow will change. It's a political question. Unless we resolve the political question, all other questions will not be resolved. The economy, the healthcare system, the education system, and it's insidious. It's insidious. You know, this education, we're talking about the quality of health workers. It starts in the PRE. That's where it begins. It begins in where homes that are broken, you know, where our children come from. So it's a whole range of things, but the starting point is politics. There are many people say, I don't engage in politics. There is no way you are going to run away from politics. Politics is what you live in, and we had better focus there. All of us get engaged. That's how these things will get. So, and let's not be, you know, if there are a lot of partisanship, you know, this is opposition. There is no opposition or government here. This is a question of justice. Yeah. Whether we are all treated equally by this country. Whether we have equal voices, and we cannot be treated equally when you have no voice. We must have a voice for you to be served. The country serves people who have power. If you have no power, you have none. You have no share. So let's fight for that power, all of us together. Thank you very much.